it's probably easier to explain what I'm doing here. So this is where my power comes into the shop. And obviously this is the outside corner of the shop. My concrete drive goes a little bit past where the shop ends, and right on the other side of this, there's a garden bed. So basically we're gonna take this panel out, turn it into a gate so I can access the phase converter that I'm gonna put out there. And I'm also gonna put together another compressor that I'm gonna stick outside. And then the plan is to pour a concrete pad to mount those on and build a lean-to over them and maybe even extend the gate slightly past just to kind of keep them contained. We're gonna start by getting this gate down. There's a bunch of plants here that we've got to transplant. We gotta dig them out and then move them and then get it ready for pouring a concrete pad. So that's where we're headed now.
Thank you.
these are used railroad ties, and they're cheap, but I don't like that little gash right there that's missing, so I'm gonna flip this all the way around. The other side looks a little better. Much better. Check out these pants. They're made by Bluklauda, I believe is how you say it. And they've got these built-in knee pad slots. that these go in. And then there's a flap inside that you pull down and around the bottom of it that holds them in, keeps them from sliding out. So one for each knee, obviously, and then gets built-in knee pads. One thing I'll tell you about knee pads, having run a landscape design and construction business for 10 plus years, is the knee pads, I never had a pair of these when I was running my company. The knee pads that you buy that have the actual knee pad itself, they always have the straps. Well, those straps cut into the back of your leg if you get them too tight. They slip down, they're always moving, you're always pulling them back up or adjusting them. One nice thing about these is that they don't move. They're literally right there. There's nothing cutting off circulation to your leg or giving you a sore on the back of your leg. It's literally just right there, right when you need it. You bend your knee and boom, you're down on a knee pad. And they're easily removable. Maybe not as quick as the knee pads with straps because you got to pull it out. But definitely an awesome addition to a pair of everyday work pants. along this line here, there's a gap where when I'm mixing concrete, it leaks out. So we're just gonna weld that shut. You can see the light coming through right there along that edge. Well, if that's not the crappiest weld you've ever seen, doesn't really matter though. At the end of the day, it's only really about sealing it up so that the water that's in the concrete mix doesn't leak out when it's up like that, so that it doesn't make a mess until we dump it into the pan. So it'll work. Plus this piece here is a cast iron and this is steel, and so not really the proper way to do this, but on this old piece of junk, really don't care. So no leak there, and we'll see how it goes once we mix up some concrete. I have seriously almost impaled myself on this handle so many times. So I don't know if you're familiar with gaffer's tape. Gaffer Power is a company that makes gaffer's tape, largely used in the music industry, setting up stages and different things. It sticks really well to itself, but then peels up with no adhesive left behind. I love it. It comes in tons of colors. I'm going to use orange here to basically just mark this handle a little better so I don't stab myself. Naughty doggies. Oh well, we'll fix it. All right, so we got the additional section of fence around that pad so that we can basically access it from the inside and not have to open a gate or whatever, and it's nice and safe and accessible if need be. Okay, so here's another look coming in off the driveway. Basically, we got the pad poured. The plan with this compressor tank is I've got another compressor pump and an electric motor, and I figured why not put them together and at some point have another compressor sitting out here that I can use. And so I cleaned up the tank and then painted it black, and it's all capped off right now. But when I get around to it, I've got it already here on the pad. And then I've got a good space between it and the three-phase converter so that I can potentially, I've got another piece of equipment that may go in here. And then the American Rotary Phase Converter itself. So we're gonna basically mount it right about there. Not quite sure, it might move a little bit. And then right there is where the power comes into the shop. So right on the other side of this wall is the single phase panel. So the three phase panel will go right next to it, and we will wire straight into the shop and then back out of the phase converter into the three phase panel, which is why I basically put it right at this location. And so right here is where the jointer was, and it'll end up going right back there for now. But I was gonna initially do a gate here and just use the fence panel that was here and turn it into a gate, but I wanted to be able to access whatever I have here. So if I put a compressor, or if I put, you know, the phase converter or something else, I want to be able to walk right to it and either work on it or take a look at it or whatever. So the other plan is I plan to make some sort of a lean-to right here. So a slight roof that will keep these things out of the direct weather. And it wouldn't be too hard now that I've got the fence framed in like this. I can just extend up off the post there and then attach some sort of a, either probably sheet metal roof to it. Just to keep stuff from, especially once I get the compressor pump and the motor out here, I don't really want those getting wet. This phase converter is rated to be outdoors. It's an AI 20 horsepower phase converter, indoor or outdoor unit. It is fully sealed. It is amazingly well put together. The next video is definitely going to be including getting it all set up, getting the panels installed, and then we're going to start up some of this equipment. So I don't know if some of these machines, like this big bandsaw, I don't know if that motor runs. I don't know if the jointer motor runs. And I got a ton more stuff in the shop that I'd like to power up and just give it a shot and see if they work. Having three phase, I knew I was gonna do it at some point and didn't know when it was gonna happen. But now that I have a three phase converter, I can start getting some of these machines up and running and getting them tested out. So stay tuned. We're going to do the rest of the install, as well as some other information on phase converters and single and three phase power in part two of this two-part series. So hope you enjoyed the construction side of it, and I'll catch you on the next one. You guys have a good one.